Hello again, Mr. True. Today we're going to talk about combining functions, leading up to the next video, which is going to be about composite functions. But in combining functions with function notation, we're simply going to add, subtract, multiply, and divide polynomials together, or functions together. And I'm going to work on two examples, I hope, with you, if I can fit it in my 15 minutes. We're also going to talk a little bit about domain. Now, when you look at an algebraic equation, your domain is always going to be all real numbers, unless your x is in the denominator, which means there might be a possibility you could divide by zero. So your domain will be all values except for what makes the denominator equal to zero. Or your x might also be in an even root, often that's square root, but an even root. You cannot take the even root of a negative number. So what's inside that radical, often square root sign, will have to be made sure that it is greater than or equal to zero. So let's start off with a couple of functions here. F of x is equal to 2x squared plus 6x plus 4. And g of x is going to be x plus 1. Now, when you talk about domain, you want to make sure you look at the domain of the two parts and the final answer. And all of those have to have, you have to meet the requirements of all three of those parts. This is a regular polynomial. No division, no square root. Same over here. So both of these parts have all real numbers for their domain, negative infinity to positive infinity. Let's see what it looks like, and I'll have to erase these examples as we go, but let's see what the addition looks like. F plus g of x. Well, you literally just take the functions and add them together. So f plus g of x is equal to f of x, which is 2x squared plus 6x plus 4, plus g of x, which is x plus 1. Now, I'm showing the parentheses to highlight the f and the g, but with just a addition sign in the middle, those parentheses really aren't going to do anything. So, let's add like terms. We've got 2x squared. We have just the x's, so those are like terms. 6 plus 1 is 7. And we have the like terms, the constants of 4, and that's fine. That's another regular polynomial, nothing fancy going on, so the domain is going to be all real numbers, negative infinity to positive infinity. Let's take a look at subtraction. Well, this one is, of course, almost the same, f minus g of x, but now here the parentheses are going to do more business, because the negative in front of these parentheses will have to get distributed through. So don't forget to do that or you'll have a sign error. So we have a 2x squared plus 6x plus 4. Negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. And I often break out into weird, crazy, completely wrong accents just to kind of like liven up my class because, hey, it is math, right? So just, you know, every once in a while if I act a little weird, you just have to live with it. 2x squared, liven things up a little bit. 2x squared, like terms of 6 and negative 1, is 5x. And then 4 minus 1 is 3. Again, all polynomials, so all real numbers are your domain. Let's talk about multiplication. F, g of x. Well, that's going to be 2x squared plus 6x plus 4 times x plus 1. I hate how everyone says FOIL, because FOIL doesn't work once you have more than two terms in one of your polynomials. So I'm distributing these together. Each one of these lines I like to draw as multiplication just to make sure you connect all the dots. And let's see what happens. 2x squared times x is 2x to the third, and then x times 6x is 6x squared, x times 4 is 4x, and then let's go to the 1 times, well actually multiply 1 nothing happens, right? So I'm just going to copy this polynomial down again for the plus 1. So 2x squared times the 6, x, and then the 4. And of course, after you get done with your distributive property, you will have to add like terms. So that's a cube, so that stays the same. 6x squared and 2x squared is 8x squared. 4 and 6 is 10, plus 4. Now again, all polynomials, so all real numbers for domain. Let's get to the division. I'm going kind of fast because I know you can pause this anytime you want to see the example a little bit slower. And I want to get to ones that have some fractions in it, which is a bit more entertaining. I also want to talk about factoring with this question. So, with finally the division, I just realized I erased my f and g, but thankfully I've written over there. So, f over g of x. Well, function f was 2x squared plus 6x plus 4 over x minus or plus 1. Now see, here we're going to have an issue with domain. We cannot divide by 0. So if you plug in negative 1, you're going to be attempting to do that, which is a no-no. So x cannot equal 1. That's going to help me on my domain in a second. Now what do I do for factoring this? Well, my pre-calc kids haven't seen this yet, so if you're watching this video, you get a little bit of a heads up. I'm going to take the first and last number and multiply them together. So it's kind of looks some little scratch work over here. 2 times 4 equals 8. Now I'm going to look for factors of 8 that add to that middle number. Well, you got 1 and 8 and 2 and 4. 2 and 4 add up to 6. So I'm going to do something called factor by grouping. First and last, multiply them together, get a product, and look for factors of that product that add to the middle term. 2 and 4. So I'm going to write that as 2x squared plus 4x plus 2x. The 4 and 2 are coming from my factors of 8, plus 4 over x plus 1. These two terms both have an x, so that comes out, and the 2. So 2x squared divided by 2x is x, 4x divided by 2x is 2. And these two have a common factor of 2, so I'm going to take out that 2. Now, when I do that, 2 divided by 2 is 1x, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. Look it, I got a match again. And that is over x plus 1. So now what do I have? Now I have two terms that both have a factor of x plus 2. That's now going to get pulled out. And we get 2x plus 2 times x plus 2 over x plus 1. Well, seems like nothing is canceling, and maybe nothing will, and this might be my final quotient answer, but 2x plus 2, both of these have a factor of 2. So now if I pull that out, I get 2 times x plus 1. Ah, look at there. The denominator cancels out, and my final quotient, my final answer, is 2 times x plus 2, or you could write that as 2x plus 4. Now, this is a regular polynomial. It's defined everywhere. But the original problem that I originally started off with before I simplified, again, you cannot divide by 0, so x, did you catch that mistake? X cannot be negative 1. So my domain for this problem are my x's such that it goes from negative infinity to negative 1 or negative 1 to positive infinity and beyond. And that's my domain based on this problem because you cannot divide by 0. Let's see how much of the next example I can get done before I run out of time. Hopefully, I don't. So we have f of x is equal to 3 plus 1 over x, and g of x is equal to 1 over x. Now both of these are undefined at 0, so that's a restriction on the domain. Let's see what it looks like when you add them. 3 plus 1 over x plus 1 over x. We already have common denominators with our fractions, so this really isn't quite as bad as it could be. 3 plus 1 plus 1 is 2, so 3 plus 2 over x. And if you'd like to find a common denominator, if your teacher wants only one term, you can find a common denominator by multiplying top and bottom by 3, and it's 3x plus 2 over x. So addition. Subtraction will be the same way, except the x's are going to cancel out, Oh look, this is also undefined at 0. I was about to skip the subtraction, but I want to emphasize the domain stuff again. 3 plus 1 over x minus 1 over x. Well, anything minus itself is 0. So, we just end up with 3. Now, y equals 3, or f minus g of x equals 3. That's a horizontal line. Those are defined everywhere. But yet, the domain cannot include 0 because that would make your original two parts undefined. I'm going to skip the multiplication because I do think I'm getting kind of close on time. Let's see here. La la la! Yes, I am. I got 3 minutes left. Let's skip to the division. So, what does f divided by g look like? This always scares people with all the fractions. F of x is 3 plus x, 1 over x, excuse me. And I'm doing f over g of x. All right. Over g of x. So that's 1 over x. This is a big mess. Could be worse, but you have fractions over fractions, and that causes a lot of confusion with my students sometimes, especially at the end of the year. What you want to do is get one fraction on top and one fraction on the bottom. When you do that, or after you do that, let's actually do that now before I lose track of where I'm going. Top and bottom by x, and we get 3x plus 1 over x over 1 over x. Now, I think I have time to explain this. Fraction bars mean division, right? So maybe back in grammar school you were doing like 1 half divided by 2 thirds, and your teacher would talk about how you couldn't actually divide fractions. You were only allowed to multiply. So you'd have to flip that second number and change the division to multiplication. Well, that second number that you're flipping, that's what this is. Top divided by the bottom. The top divided by the bottom. So it's the bottom one that's always going to get flipped, and the division has to get changed to multiplication. So I've adopted my little pigtail diagram or notation, and we're going to flip the bottom up. You do this every time you have one fraction over one fraction. You can flip the bottom up and change that division to multiplication. Now, this comes out to be 3x plus 1 times 1 is 3x plus 1 over x times x is x squared. That will not simplify anymore. It is again undefined at x equals 0 because you can't divide by 0, and that is combining functions. Bam! Have a great day.